How many people did it take to build the Great Pyramid? The estimates as to how this was done are pretty dramatic and don't logically weigh up or make sense, especially if you consider a 10-hour working day and the need for a placement of a block every 2 minutes for 25 years. Something isn't adding up. How do we assume the 25-year timeline anyway? These figures are taken from two sources. The first being the reign of Khufu. He reigned for at least 23 years, according to the Turin Papyrus. And this would mean the pyramid would need to be envisioned, planned out, the work being carried out, and complete before the king's death. This is what the history books teach us, despite the fact that engineers and architects the world over tell us that 100 years to carry out such a project would be a push, never mind one generation. The fact of the matter is that our education system is pushing on the boundaries of what we will accept as logical. Just because we are told something happened, it doesn't mean it actually happened, and the evidence in the case of Khufu, being a king who ordered the construction of the Great Pyramid, is one that is forcing the hand of the civilized people of the earth. How can we believe something so outlandish that if we were to believe this, then we would be letting down future generations in our understanding of things that have went before. The Greek historian Herodotus tells us of his understanding. Remember, Herodotus had access to the history books of the Egyptian civilization at Alexandria, so his understanding could be conveyed as more of an overview as he visited 2,000 years after the reign of Khufu. Herodotus tells us that this is written that 100,000 men completed the pyramid in 20 years. He tells us this 2,000 years after Khufu reigned, and the texts he takes his knowledge from are no longer in existence. 100,000 men at work on the Giza Plateau would have been a mega operation, and it is entirely unclear how they fed these workers, housed them, clothed them, and their families. This would have been enormous, a population of pyramid builders that would have been equivalent to the population of Cairo City in 1800. What about the tools used in the working of the very hard raw materials used? Well, what if we were to tell you guys that such a tool has never been found? It has long been assumed that the use of chisels and hammers in the shaping of stone, but no such tools have ever been found, ever. The fact of the matter is that we are confronted with evidence of the use of advanced technology at these locations. How ancient builders cut through granite and basalt like butter is the most perplexing questions in existence. How they then move these very dense stones is another brain buster, but the cutting and drilling that we still see present of the Giza Plateau means that whatever they used must have been harder than quartz minerals that granite is composed of. This suggests the use of a diamond, as that is what we use to cut granite today, with one exception. The ancient cuts are more accurate than the modern cuts under a microscope, further adding to the massive enigma. The historian and scholar Abd al-Latif tells us that in the 12th century, the Great Pyramid is covered with an indecipherable language. This is probably dynastic hieroglyphics, and this is a great clue in our understanding of the Great Pyramid, because this tells us that it survives mostly intact till the 12th century. It still had its casing at this time, and apparently it was covered with glyphs, shortly after it was stripped for the purposes of building Cairo City, until the casing was gone. Important stones like the Rosetta Stone has since been recovered as building material, but the true scale of the loss of the ancient stone documents is out of this world. By the Middle Kingdom of Egypt, the Old Kingdom had already been forgotten about. The knowledge had already been forgotten, and this seems to confuse Middle Kingdom rulers somewhat. Khufu the King was already a character from history, as opposed to still having an influence at all, and 550 after this king reigned, his reliefs and hieroglyphic inscriptions seem to have almost vanished from time. The Great Pyramid, as we now know, has no inscription whatsoever, with the exception of the fake cartouche that attributes it to Khufu. These pyramids on the Giza Plateau are remnants of an era that was already bygone to the dynastic Egyptians, including Khufu. It should strike the viewers of the Lost History Channel as an absolute assumption that Khufu built the pyramid within this time frame. We get the range from his reign of 23 years, despite this being impossible, and we get Khufu as a king from the compiling by Manetho of a king list that is still the basis for all framework in our dating of the Egyptian kings. This is despite Manetho living two centuries after Herodotus and his original king's list being lost, but translations written. We rely on this despite it being inaccurate, to a degree of being impossible regarding the old kingdom of Egypt and Khufu. This characterization and grouping of the 30 dynasties are probably just popular tradition of the following dynasties trying to recall the old kingdom. Many ancient stories surround the Great Pyramid of Giza. One of our favorites is that of the story of King Sirrid, who lived three centuries before the Great Flood. The king was bothered by his dreams he would have, in which he sees chaos on the land, and only those who would join the Lord of the Boat would survive. The presence of the solar barge at the Great Pyramid and the association of Ra with the solar barge has eerie echoes of the story of Noah. Arab legend maintains that the Great Pyramid was the tomb of Hermes, the Greek counterpart of the god Thoth. Just like the king Sirrid, he built the pyramid to preserve science and literature after the Great Flood. That is all from us for the moment. More evidence and understanding as to why we don't believe the Great Pyramid on the Giza Plateau was built by a king named Khufu. To consider that this industrious feat of engineering majesty is a tomb for a king who ruled over a primitive people, fighting back from the brink of extinction after the cataclysm, is mind-boggling to us. We simply cannot connect the King Khufu with the Great Pyramid construction, so why are we believing it as a fact? What do you guys think about this anyway?
Thanks for watching. Drop a like. Leave a comment. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel, Design Hysterics. Get more updated videos from now. Click on the bell button below to get notified. See you people in the next video. Till then, it's a bye from Design Hysterics team.